30 legislators are at the center of a multi-agency investigation into the alleged mismanagement and embezzlement of funds amounting to 164.7 billion shillings, which was released to compensate members of the cooperative unions who lost property during war times. According to the Minister of State for Trade, Harriet Ntabazi, CID police and the DPP sanctioned files against legislators implicated in the scam.
The CID is taking on files. Around five files have been identified, and the good thing with it, it wasn't only the ministry. There are members of parliament, more than 30 members of parliament, who are into this.
Ntabazi noted that on the list of the suspected lawmakers are five noisy opposition legislators who are going to face the law,
including opposition members of parliament, five active opposition members of parliament, very talkative and noisemakers, will also face it wrath.
The minister recognizes that the Minister of Trade is in hot soup over the mess.
We shall face it wherever it will end, God knows. Let it unfold that way. Because the pressures were coming from the committees of budget, the committees of what, the cooperatives and others, members who are in parliament, others outside the parliament. We are not scared. We shall undertake it because it is now beyond us.
The Trade Committee report highlighted that some compensations were made on unverified claims, while there was a general lack of appreciation of the rationale for compensation to cooperatives for war losses.
But to reach the level where there were some suspicious cooperatives, which they were non-existent, that's why Auditor General picked interest. So the Auditor General picked interest and carried out an audit. Auditor General reported it to Parliament. So this matter had been discussed in the Public Accounts Committee Central.
It's now up to DPP to look at that report, okay? And if he feels there is a need for further investigations, they will investigate.
Committee members were asked to learn that the Minister of Trade went on to disburse more 36.318 billion to 18 cooperative unions for war loss claims in the last financial year, yet they had recommended a halt of payments.
Now at the same time you say we have created more cooperatives, that's why we want more clarity. Now what type of cooperatives are you creating?
Unless these things of the cooperative, it has been cleared completely, I'm going to be one of those who will walk out of the parliament when someone brings that he's going to give money to cooperatives.
The Parliamentary Committee of Trade, which investigated the matter in October, discovered that payments amounting to 48.77 billion shillings were made in excess and outside the allocated amounts to various cooperatives. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.